Good morning, everyone. So in the last session, we discussed about the one of the important example on this particular Spring JDBC, as well as we identify the name mode parameter JDBC template, how it is going to work internally. Okay, so today we are going to discuss one of the another important example called Hibernate here. Okay, so first we'll identify the Hibernate related section, and later we'll discuss about the Spring with the Hibernate. Okay, now whatever the basic Hibernate concepts we are going to have, we'll discuss here, and later how we can integrate with the Spring and Hibernate. So those sections we are going to discuss here. Okay, so to understand more about this particular Hibernate, now what do we need? So the basic concepts we need here, like what is the persistence basically. Okay, so persistence, whenever we are trying to discuss about this particular Hibernate, we are going to discuss more about this particular concepts here. Okay, so what is this particular persistence means here? So persistence basically is one of the fundamental concepts we are going to use in our application development here. So basically, in times of this particular Java, what we will do, we are going to store the data into the relational database with using this particular SQL queries here. This is important here, and this is the fundamental concepts we are going to use in our day-to-day application development here. So what it will do, it will try to communicate with our database. Get in mind, it is going to communicate with our database, our using our Java language. And here, what is the query language we are using? SQL you are using. So internally, even though we are using this particular Hibernate query language, internally the Hibernate query language, it will convert it into the SQL only. Okay, so this is we need to understand here. Whenever we are trying to implement the application, so with the help of this particular Java, now we are trying to communicate with the database using the HQL or SQL, this particular concept we'll call it as a persistence here. Okay, this is one of the important concept we need to understand, because anything you are going to write here, so we are going to use this particular persistence mechanism here. And here what we can understand here, this particular relational database, it is not specific to the our Java. Not only this Java, you can communicate with the other languages also. So using the other languages also, we can implement this particular relational database here. Getting the point, and this is important, and this is the relational database here. So it is not specific to the any applications here. It is not specific to the any application. So first one, it is not specific to the any language, and it is not specific to the any application. So this particular relational technology, it is going to provide the sharing the data among the different applications with the different technologies here. This is the main advantage we are going to get from this particular Hibernate here. The Hibernate is one of the relational database here. The relational database, basically it is not specific to the any application. It is not specific to the any language here. Get in the point. It is going to share the information about the different application with the different technologies here. Okay, so there is no static information. You can see, so this is the database here. This database with the different languages we are going to connect here. Okay, and here, and each language can use the relational database management here, RDM. Okay, this is important here. Now we'll understand this Hibernate related sections here. So what we are doing basically, so in our Hibernate internally, as I explained here, we are going to use the SQL language. Even though you are using the Hibernate query language, we are going to convert those section into the structured query language, SQL. So what is the basic here? Getting the point. Whenever we are trying to discuss about this particular Hibernate, so we need to understand the basic SQL information. So what we will do basically, first we'll use a DDL command. Getting the point. So what is the DDL command basically? This is nothing but a data definition language. So DDL is nothing but data definition language. Now we'll create the table, okay, or alter the table. Like alter is nothing but modifying the table. So these two comes under the DDL here. whatever we are discussing here, this is the DDL, something like a data definition language here. Now, what it will do? It will try to create the table or it will try to modify the table. Okay, so once a DDL is completed, now we need to understand the DML here. So what exactly the DML will contain? It is containing the data manipulation language. So getting the point, DDL is nothing but data definition here, and DML is nothing but data manipulation. So manipulation is nothing but here we are going to use insert, update, getting the point, insert, update and deletion here. This is important. So in here, insert, update and deletions we are going to use here. So this is comes under the this particular DML. These two sections we already identified, this DDL and DML, whenever we are trying to discuss about the JDBC here. Because so JDBC internally we create the table called person. Get in the point. In the person, the table creation will comes under this particular DDL and so using the template like JDBC template or named parameter template, we updated the, inserted the and deleted the record from the table here. So these are all the DMS related section we already identified in the previous examples here. But even when we are trying to discuss about the Hibernate internally, it is going to use the same SQL here. So this is important, we need to understand here. Okay, now what you can understand here? Along with this particular DDL and DML, we have other information. So those are not required at this time. We'll discuss later how these particular sections are going to work here. But now we'll try to identify the another important sections called ORM here. Getting the point. We'll try to communicate the all the Hibernate related section with help of this particular ORM. So ORM is nothing but the object to relational mapping here. So whenever we are discussing this example ORM related here, what are the different layers we are going to use here? What are the different layers we are going to use? So first one, as we discuss here, first one is presentation layer. Okay, this is, we'll call it as a presentation layer, and the second one we'll call it as a business layer. And so third one we'll call it as a persistence layer. So this particular persistence layer only we are going to discuss more here. Getting the point? This one only we'll discuss more here. But in the real-time application, so these are all the different layers we are going to have. First one is presentation layer and second one is business layer. The presentation layer we are going to call it as a controller related. Okay. And this one we'll call it as a service related. And this one we'll call it as a the repository, whatever we discuss here. Okay, whatever the repository we discuss here. And finally, this is nothing but database here. Getting them. And these are all the different layer we are going to have in the real-time applications. And we'll try to communicate the all the database related section inside the persistence layer here. Okay, now the persistence layer basically it will try to communicate the database to store the information inside the database here. This is another important example. We need to understand the different layers what we are going to use here. And so another section we need to discuss about the ORM here. This is very important here, the object relational mapping. Okay, how this particular object relational mapping is going to work. So Hibernate internally, it is a one of the ORM technique. So with help of this particular ORM only, the Hibernate is going to work here. Getting the point? And what we can understand here, so object relational mapping, basically it is a automated. This particular ORM is internally automated. So what exactly it will do? And it will try to create the persistence object in our Java Applet with the same the tables information. Getting the point? So what exactly it will do in the inside this particular ORM, the whatever the Java objects we are going to create in our application, with help of this particular objects here internally, it will try to create the tables here, tables in the relational databases. So this is important here. Getting the point? So whatever this particular object to relational mapping we are using here, with the help of this particular object to relational mapping, based on the Java objects here, the same names in the relational database are going to created. So automatically it is going to created. So how it is going to created? So we need to understand the what are the different configurations we need to use to create the object in our the particular section called relational databases here. Okay, now we'll identify here how it is going to work internally, and after creation of this particular example, we'll try to perform the same operation. So whatever this particular operations we identified, like cut operations here, it will try to create, update, and read the data as well as delete the data. Okay, so it will try to create the informations here, and so this is the creation, and it is something like updation, and this is something like read, and something like deletion. So these are all the code operations also we can perform with the help of this particular ORM technique and using our relational databases here. Getting the point? So as I discuss here, we are trying to use this particular ORM to include our persistence layer here. Getting the point? Because Hibernate internally, it is one of the ORM technique here. Getting the point? So if it is the ORM technique, we are going to use the persistence layer here. And whatever this particular SQL queries we are going to use, so automatically what happens internally, it will try to convert into the database specific here. Whatever the database we are going to use, so it will try to convert it into the database query language here. And here, what we need to understand here, so we are not going to including this particular persistence layer where this particular object and relational mapping is going to use here. Getting the point? So wherever we are trying to use this particular relational mapping, we are going to use it. Now we'll understand here how this particular ORM is going to work here. So to understand this particular ORM, now what we can understand here, what we need to understand, so we need to discuss about the simple example here. So what are the simple example we can implement with the help of this particular ORM in our Hibernate here. So how this particular examples are going to work. Now let's see, understand here how it is going to work internally. We'll create the first classes here, and later we'll try to discuss about the table sections here. So meanwhile, I will open this particular table, and here inside the Spring Core only, now I'm going to create the one more package here. Getting the pen? Here I'm going to create the one more package, something like JDBC we discuss here. So same way, I'm going to create the Hibernate here. Okay, so these are all comes under the Hibernate here. Now, so whenever we are providing this particular Hibernate, here we need to add the dependency here, because we are using the same, the whatever the form file we are using here. So something like a same form file. So we'll go for the Maven repository. Okay, inside the Maven repository, so what is the jar, like what is the Hibernate related jar we need to use here? Something like Hibernate core here. Okay, Hibernate core. So I'm going to use this. We'll go for the same the three related sections whatever we are using here. Now we can go for this particular final sections here, not the beta CR1 CR2, because these are not yet completed yet. We need to understand the final related section. Okay, now I am using the 3.6.2 here. I'm copying this the versions here, and I'm trying to paste it here. Okay, the Hibernate sections we added here, Hibernate core here. So once we added this particular Hibernate core, now what I'm doing is I'm going to I'm going to create a one class, and this particular class we are going to use under the Hibernate. Using the Hibernate, we are going to store into the Postgres database here. So now what I will do here, if we are having any the previous example, I'm going to delete. Only we are having only public schema we are having, and we'll create a one more connection, the Postgres connection we are going to create. And so what is the database we need to use? Something like a Hibernate. And what is the password we are going to use? Postgres. Now use the test connection. So database Hibernate, it does not exist here. Now what is the main step first? What is the main step we need to do? We need to create the database here. So inside the Postgres, create a new database here. Now I'm trying to create here. Hibernate I'm trying to create here. Okay, Hibernate is created. So to understand this particular Hibernate, if I'm going to use one more connection, so this will give you the Hibernate related section. Okay, so the connection is passed here. Now I'm trying to click on this finish here. Now if you see here we are having Hibernate here. Inside the Hibernate, what is the database we are having? Same Hibernate here. So you can change this particular name, anything, but we'll keep as it is here. But database Hibernate we are using. Okay, so this is important. Now we'll go back to the same here. Now what I will do, this is important here. Now I'm going to create a one class. What is the class we are going to use here? Something like a message class we are going to use here. And this message class will contain the what all the information we need to understand, right? Now this particular same message we are going to create in the database called the my like message table. And now what I'm doing here, I'm going to create the long ID. So private string. And what we can identify here, so text here. And now if you observe carefully, message I'm adding here. Okay, message, this is important here. And next to message, private message, next to message. Now what I will do here, I'm going to generate the default constructor. After this, and here this dot text is equals to text here. Okay, so this is the second text, like a second constructor we are creating. And after this, now what I will do, I'm going to generate the setters here, setters and getters. Now you can see what we are doing is void YAML. This is wrong. Now you can see message class we created. These are all the three properties we are having. First one is ID property. Second one is long property, like text properties. And another one is next message. It is having the type call message. So here we are using the object type here. Whatever the object type we are having here, something like message, the same class I'm trying to refer here. So these are all the important section we need to understand. Okay, now we created this particular message table. Now if you see carefully what we are doing here, we are trying to refer to the another message here. Something like next message is nothing but we are trying to ascend to the next message. So we'll identify itself like this particular message, how it is going to communicate with the help of this particular next messages here. Okay, now you can see what we are going to do. We'll try to create the same object, the same table in our database, but we are not going to create the table. The table, it should be automatically created here. Now we need to understand here how this particular table it is going to create automatically. So basically what we are going to do here, if I want to create an object here, so simply I'm creating the main method. We'll delete later this particular main method, but now observe what I'm doing here. So message, whatever the message we are having, and new message. So here I'm passing the text message, something like what is the message we can write here. Welcome to Hibernate. Okay, so this is the message. Now what happens internally, if I'm going to print this message dot get text here, whenever I'm trying to print this particular get text here internally, it will try to print this particular welcome to Hibernate. But what we are expecting is this, whatever the same message we are having here, this message it should print in like it should save in our database here. So there we are creating an object, we are trying to printing the same object, but what we are expecting is the same object it should be save in the databases here, save in the databases. So this is important, we need to understand here. Okay, so how we are going to do, so to perform the same example here, now what we will do here, instead of creating this particular session, like instead of creating this particular message object, we need to create the session information. Okay, so how we are going to get the session? So to like basically, so using the session we are going to communicate with the database here. So to understand more here, we need to communicate the connection first. Getting the point? We need to communicate the connection, right? So how we are going to make the connection to the whatever the database, the Postgres database we are using. So the same connection we need to use here. So now observe, if I want to get this particular connection, now what we need to do, first we need to create the mapping file. Getting the point? First we need to create the mapping file. So the mapping file in our source directory only I'm going to create the file here. The file, the mapping file, it should be mapped with whatever the class name we are going to use here. Getting the point? Whatever this particular class name we are using, it should satisfy the naming convention with the same here. So let me create this particular file here, something like okay, so this is the message.hbm.xml. So what exactly this particular mapping file will contain here? So now first what we can do, we need to add this particular DTD. So to add this DTD, now what we will do, so I'm copying from the Google. So this is the DTD we are going to use here. Getting the point? This is important. So we already discussed this particular DTD, how it is going to work here. So if I want to show you this particular information, how this particular DTD it is going to work internally, let me open the new browser, run this particular DTD. Now you can see what is doing internally. So it is trying to download the DTD file. Okay, so here inside this particular D drive I'm trying to use. And using the notepad plus I'm trying to open. So this is the particular DTD information. So whatever the DTD we are having, now these particular properties only we are going to use internally whenever we are trying to discuss about the all the XML related example. Okay, for example, what we will do, what kind of the properties we are going to use it. Now you can see, so first one is Hibernate mapping. So internally it will try to use the class, subclass, join to subclass. Okay, these are all the mappings we are going to use it. And here we are going to provide the schema, and we are going to provide the default cascade here. So cascade by default, basically it is none here. Okay, by default it is basically none. And the same thing you can see auto import here. So package information, and another one here, something like import related section. Now if we come back to the class section, class will contain, these are all the different properties, something like meta, you can use the cache, id, composite id, discriminator, getting the print. So version, timestamp, so these are all the properties we are going to use. So now you can see, so property, something like menu 1, 1 to 1, component, dynamic component, like a map, set, list, these are all the different the properties we are going to use here. And the same thing, now you can go for the class name, class class table, schema, proxy. So we have a different the properties we are having here. These properties we are going to use in our Hibernate the mapping document here. Okay, this is the mapping document we are going to use. Based on this particular mapping document, what happens internally, so it is trying to create the object in our Postgres database here. This is important. What is the first tag we are going to use? Hibernate mapping. So just now we discuss here from where this particular Hibernate mapping is coming here. Now if you read this here, that highest tag, Hibernate mapping. Okay, Hibernate mapping, and we are going to close this particular Hibernate mapping. Under this particular Hibernate mapping, these are all the different mappings we are going to use. Okay, after this particular Hibernate mapping, now I'm going to use class tag here. So what is the name of the class? Getting the point. So what is the name of the class we are using? So it should be fully qualified name here. Com dot, what we are using the package name, com dot spring dot Hibernate. Okay, so this is the package name, and this is the class name, com dot spring dot Hibernate is the package, and after this we are trying to defining as a message. So this is the particular package here. So after this, now what is another information we can use, something like a table. So what is the table we are going to use here? Same name, so message here. Okay, the message name I'm trying to give, whenever we are giving this, it is going to create internally the same message table here. Okay, after this, what we can understand here, we need to understand the ID properties. So what is the ID property? ID property, how this particular ID value, what kind of the data type we are using, and how it is going to generated internally, the section we are going to discuss here. Okay, now what we need to understand here, okay, so ID, what we can give here, this is important, we need to understand here, getting the point. So whatever this particular ID, now first we need to come up with the name. Okay, name of the column here. What is the name of the column we are using? Something like ID only. Okay, so after this, what are the other properties we need to use here? Column we need to use here. What is the column we need to use? The name of the column, now I'm going to use something like this. Message underscore ID. Okay. So after this particular message underscore ID, and internally we need to use one of the important section called generator. This is very important example we need to, like the property tag we need to use very carefully. Okay, so after completion of this particular ID, internally I'm going to use a generator. Okay, I'm going to use this particular generator. This is important. So this particular generator, internally it will give you the value, how we want to provide the value for this particular ID. Now what I'm doing here, I'm using increment here. I'm using increment section. So this is all about the ID related. Now what we will do, we'll try to use the property tag here. We are going to use this particular property tag. What is the name of the property tag? We define inside this particular message call something like text here, and what is the column name we are going to use. So this is important here, message underscore name, or we can provide as a text here, message underscore text is the best column name here. Okay, so column name we provided. After providing this particular column name, now what I'm doing here, I'm going to provide the relation here, many to one. This is important, many to one, because the next message we are going to provide as a many, and it is going to map to the parent message class here. Getting the point. This is important here. The association, we will call it as a basically. We'll discuss more about this particular association, but now we need to understand how the another column we have. The column we have here, something like next message. So if I'm going to show you where we define message here. Now you can see here we define the ID property, we define the text property. Now we are trying to define with this particular next property. Now this is the next message. Basically, it is not a string or any other data type. It is a object type. Whenever it is an object type, we need to define the association like one to one, one to many, or many to many. We need to define here. Now what I'm doing here, I'm trying to define many to one. Okay. So now you can see here what is the name we have here. Something like your next message. The column name we need to provide. So this is the property name next message, and internally we need to map it to the which column here. Internally we need to map it to the which column. Something like I'm going to provide the column name. So here next message ID. Next message ID. This is the column we are going to use, and another important we are going to use here, something like a cascade here. So basically cascade by default, it is none. It is not going to provide any the dependency information. If I'm going to provide all here, getting the point. If I'm going to provide all, what happens internally, it will try to update the information. It will try to delete the information in the dependence table here. So basically many to one, basically how it is going to work. These are all the many objects. Okay, it is trying to map to the one object here. So here all the objects are going to map with the next message ID. Okay, whatever this particular next message ID we are going to have, this next message ID in the three objects, whatever the three objects we have right on left side, so it is going to point it to the ID. So this ID and this ID and this ID, it should match it with this particular next message ID here. Okay, it should point into this particular next message ID. So this is important here. Whenever you are trying to delete this object, this record is going to delete it from this particular message table here. So same thing, if you are trying to update something, it will affect it here. And here, if you are trying to modify, it will affect it here. Okay, this is the cascade we'll do internally. Whenever we are trying to make on the different like relational tables here, one to one or one to many, some other table here, it will try to update in the dependent tables as well here. We have a different cascade here. We'll discuss later what are the different cascade we are going to have, but right now we need to understand the how this particular example it is going to store in the Postgres database. Now I'm formatting the code here. Now you can see the main tag hibernate mapping, and the class tag we need to define, and under the class tag we have ID and property. So we have two properties we define. First one is ID, second one is the string property. So third one, basically it is something like object type. Whenever we are having the object type here, we are going to use this particular many to one, something different to tags we are going to use here. Okay, this is the mapping information. So we define this particular mapping information. So once we define this particular mapping information, now what we can do, we need to create the configurations here. Like this mapping should be stored in the database. With the help of this particular mapping file, it should be create the table in the database. But where we are going to provide the database properties information here. This is important. So where we are going to provide the database properties. So to understand the database properties, we need to work on the another important section basically. Configuration file here, the Hibernate configuration file, how we are going to use the Hibernate configuration file. This is important here. So let me copy this particular configuration. So to configure this particular file, again, I'm going to create one more file here. Hibernate.cfg.xml. This is another file we are going to use here. So whenever we are using this particular another file here, now what are the configuration information we need to provide? The configuration information basically we are going to provide something like here. Where is the configuration file? Same DTD we need here. Whatever the DTD we are using inside this particular mapping document here. So this particular DTD I am going to use, but it is basically Hibernate mapping. Now we are going to modify to the Hibernate configuration. So paste this, and this is not, we are not going to use it. So this mapping we will not use. So we'll go for the Hibernate configurations here. Okay, so let me change it. Hibernate configuration, so we can use the 2.0 DTD here. After this, now what we will do, we'll try to use the tags basically. Now Hibernate mapping, so Hibernate mapping will not use, Hibernate configuration we need to use basically. Now if you see, so sorry, this is wrong. And now let me copy this. It is loading or not, how we can check it? With help of this particular DTD file. So this is, we need to download here. Now you can see it is downloading here. So once it is downloaded, now whatever the DTD we are providing, it is correctly, it is matching here. Like with help of this particular syntax, it is matching. But right now, Hibernate, what is a, nothing is coming. So basically it is a Hibernate configuration. So once we provide this particular Hibernate config, anything we are missing? Okay, Hibernate mapping, this is also we need to change Hibernate configuration. Doc type, the doc type also we should change Hibernate configuration, because we copy from the mapping file. Because of that, we are getting all the mapping related section. Now you can see, so we are getting an error, the content element is incomplete, must match with the session factory. Okay, so he is expecting the session factory. Okay, so after providing this particular session factory, now here we need to understand here what kind of the session factory we are going to use here. This is important here. What kind of this particular session factory and what kind of the database properties we are going to use. So we are going to provide the informations under this. So after this particular session factory, we are going to use the property name. What is the name of the property? Okay, the name of the property basically will try to use the driver class name. Getting the point? We'll try to go for the driver class name. Now, what I will do, I will copy this section. We'll copy this particular section so that we can easily understand here how this particular example it is going to work internally. Now if you see, so we created the same Hibernate configuration, session factory and a property name. Now you can see Hibernate dialect. So this particular dialect we'll discuss later, because how this particular dialect is going to provide, we have some important section we need to discuss on this. And driver class name, same driver class name we use in the Spring JDBC, whatever we used here. And the connection URL, so this is the localhost connection URL. Whenever you're trying to communicate with the real-time applications here, the real-time database instead of this particular local host will specify only the IP address. Get in pan? Where this particular database is located, the IP will provide here. Get in pan? So other than this particular ID, this particular configuration is same. This particular configuration is same. So same thing, username and password and HBM2 DDL. Basically, what exactly it is doing this? This particular section, like how we want to create the particular table information. So we have a different types of these sections here. We'll discuss later here. But right now, understand here how we are trying to connecting. Getting the how we are trying to connecting this particular example with the help of this particular like Hibernate with a Postgres database here. Okay, this is we need to understand here. So we already familiar with the configurations information. So what are the different types of configurations we are having here? Okay, coming back to here, now what we need to understand here, the mapping resource. This mapping resource is, the mapping resource is very important. We need to understand here how this particular mapping is going to work internally. So 1 second. Where it is available. Okay, now you can see we have this particular Hibernate configuration, session factory, and we have a different properties we are having. Now, what you need to understand here, this is important, mapping resource. So why we are using this particular mapping resource? This particular mapping resource, basically, what kind of the table we want to create here? So we need to provide this. So what is the table configurations information? So message.hbm.xml. Message.hbm.xml file we are using here. Now the M I given as a small here. Now you can see I modified this particular example. We'll come back to this. So this is the mapping document we are using. This mapping document is going to share the information. So how the object we want to create. This mapping document is available for each and every the classes we are going to create. For each class we need to create a one mapping document. And for each class we are not going to create this particular session configurations here.
Okay, only one database, one configuration. But one database, we have a multiple tables with a multiple mapping document. So this is we need to understand here. Okay, these are all the information we provided. Now finally, inside this particular Hibernate, I am going to create a one more class. So something like Hibernate main file here. Whatever this particular Hibernate we are having here, the Hibernate main file we are going to discuss here. Okay, Hibernate main file I am creating here, and this particular Hibernate main file internally we will try to use this particular main method. Now once we create this particular main method, now what you need to understand here we need to provide the configuration related section. How we are going to provide the configuration related here? Now you can see we have a one configuration object here. From where we need to download here? This is the org-hibernate.cfg, because we added the Hibernate core related section here. Because of this we are getting here. Now I'm trying to use the same configuration here, and after this now what we can do, the configuration. So after creating this particular configuration, now what is the another important section we need to understand here? The configuration internally, it is going to call the configure. Internally it will try to call this particular configuration dot configure. Now what we can understand this particular config, now it will try to load the configuration file here. Whatever this particular config file we have, something like hibernate.cfg.xml. So where we provided this here in the source directory, we created here hibernate.cfg.xml. So once we created this, now what happens internally, with help of this particular configuration we'll try to load the session factory. We'll discuss later how this particular classes are going to work internally, but we need to understand the configuration.session factory. Okay, not a get session factory, we have a build session factory. Okay, so this is the session factory, it is going to return here, and now I'm trying to creating the session factory object. From the session factory object here, what we will do, we'll call the open session. The open session internally, it will try to return the session object here. Okay, after creating this particular session object here, now with help of this particular session dot begin transaction, this is the transaction it is going to begin. After this particular transaction, now whatever we created inside this particular message class, whatever we created this particular message class, I'm going to paste it here. I'm creating an object here, and after this I will remove this. So we don't want to use this particular main method in the one of the model class here. So I mean, coming back to here, now we'll not require this printing. Okay, so we are not going to print this section here. Now we'll call the session related example session dot save here, and we'll provide the message. Okay, after providing this, so transaction dot commit. Why we need here? We are going to save the data into the database here with help of this particular commit. And once it is completed, we can close the session here. Once a example is completed, we can close this particular session. Okay, this is important. Now what are all the steps we are following? First we created one model classes object here, one model class object we created, and another one. Now what we did basically, the another important example we created for this particular model, we come up with a HBM file, like something like a mapping file here, and we created one CFG file, like a configuration file here. CFG is nothing but configuration file. And finally we are trying to create one main here, one main class we are going to execute here. So these are all the basic example we modified right now. Now we'll see how this particular Hibernate is going to work internally. Now, whenever I'm trying to run this example, if everything is go successful, we need to get the data inside the database. But right now, we are getting an exception. Now you can see the field called next message not found in the message class here. So what we are missing basically, something like the property name we provide wrong here. So whatever the property we have, the next message, something like it is wrong here. Now we'll go to the message class here. So this is the next message, the M is capital here. But now what I did here, I hope here we provide the small. So this is the issue we are having. Now I modified this issue. Again, I'm going to run the same example. Now whenever I'm trying to run here, we'll see what happening internally. So something like Java assist util dot proxy method filter. What you understand here? So this particular method filter is expecting internally, the method filter is not available. Whatever the method filter is expecting, the method filter is not available. Now what we can do, getting point, this is important. Now what we can do, we need to add a jar here. What is the jar we need to add? Whatever the Java assistant we are having, the particular Java assistant jar we need to add. So where we can go here inside this, type the Java assist here. So now we'll go to this. And so this is modified in the May 13, 2022. So now we'll go to the latest changes, something like, so randomly I'm picking this. So anyone will work internally, we'll go to the pom.xml. And after this particular core, here I'm providing. And I'm trying to save this. So now observe, once I added this, we cannot get this particular exception one more time here. This is important. Now we'll go for the same main class. Now again, I'm trying to run the same example. Now you can see, if you observe carefully, what we are doing here. So this is the message we are getting. Now what of the message basically? So select to max message ID from the message. Okay, select the max message ID. So far, what is the max message ID? 0, because we did not insert any record right now. Getting the point? This is the SQL query. Select to max message ID from the message. It is the same SQL query it is generated. Right now, based on this particular message ID, it will try to insert here. So now you can see insert into the message text, next message ID, and message ID. These are all the values. Whatever the JDBC template we discuss here, same like, but here we did not create any table and we are not inserting any data. Just we are calling the object we saved here and we are calling the session dot save here. But first we'll go to the database. Now we'll see whether this particular database can contain any tables here. So now right now we don't have any table. Refresh this particular database here. Okay, here only Hibernate is there. So this Hibernate is not using, I hope. Which one it is using? So this is different. Oh, tables are not available. Okay, so what is the mapping like configuration file we provided? So we given as a Hibernate, H is a capital, but right now the database we don't have. Okay, so 1 second, we'll try to create one more connection. We'll see the Hibernate database is there, capital H. So this is important here. Now Postgres, the password I'm giving. Okay, connection is passed here. Now I'm trying to click on finish. So we'll see how it is connecting this databases, Hibernate, schema, public, and table we are having. Now, so whatever we provided, so it is providing this is information. So let me delete this. Okay, this is the Hibernate, the capital H Hibernate we are using internally. The database we provide as a capital H Hibernate here. Now message table, and what are the columns we are having? Now you can see the columns message ID, message text, and next message. So for example, if I'm going to run the table here, so where is the, we have browse, generate SQL, compare, from here we can run. Okay, so this is we'll use here, select star from message here. Now these are all the different one. This is the last record. Okay, he's trying to take the existing object information here, but anyway, now you can see, so this is the ninth record is created, ninth record, and welcome to Hibernate. Whatever the next message, we did not provide any next message so far here. The next message is null. The next message is null. Okay, simple example we created. Now we inserted the data into the database here. So any questions? Any questions regarding this particular example? Okay, if we don't have anything now, so we need to understand very example, like important example. Now let me delete this table. Okay, the table I deleted. Now if I'm going to run this, we'll get an error here. So the relation, basically message, does not exist here. The table is deleted. Now I'm going to run one more time here. The same example I'm going to run here. Now you can see again the object is going to create it, the table is going to create it internally, and it will insert the same record. If I'm going to run, we are getting, so the message ID 1 we are getting. Now you can think here, so this is the first record here, but how this particular one is getting? If you go to this particular code, so this is the constructor we are calling the message, but I did not set the ID here. So even though we are not setting the ID, Hibernate is going to generate the ID based on this particular property. What is the property we are using? So this is the property generator. This generator internally, it will try to provide the ID related section. We have a different types of generators here, we'll discuss later, but now I'm using the increment here. Okay, whenever we are using this particular increment, what happens internally, it will try to increment the value automatically. Okay, this particular value automatically it is going to increment it here. This is we need to understand here. Because of that, it's trying to load the first ID, whatever the message ID we have. Based on this, it will try to insert the record here. Based on this particular value, now it will try to insert it into this section. Now another important example, now what I'm trying to do here, first I will load here. So another important example, I need to provide the what. Now you can see here the same configurations, and we'll use here open session, transaction, all information. And after this, now what I'm trying to do here, I'm going to use the one more information after this particular transaction. Session dot find. Now here I'm going to provide the message from message. Okay, and here I'm trying to use as m. It is a what we can call it as a alias name. I'm using m, and now you can see. So order by. Now what I'm doing here, m dot text here. M dot text is a message, like m dot text is a property. So with help of this particular find query, we are trying to load the data. Okay, the find is deprecated. Anyway, we'll try to use this find. We can use this particular find related section here. Now, what is the return type it is providing? So after using this, I will go for the assigning here. List of records we are going to get. So list of messages here, otherwise message list here. Okay, so message list here. And the message list, basically what is the type we can provide? Here we can provide the message generic type here. Now, after this, now what I will do here, I'm going to use the iterator or any loop here, anything we can use. So simply I will check this system dot first to this message list empty or not. Just I'm going to check this empty. Okay, if it is an empty, now what we can understand here, what we can understand, we can print this. So if it is not empty, we'll go for the condition. If it is, this section is not empty, now what I will do here, I will try to load the this particular section here, message list dot, we can go for each, and message, and so we'll generate the two string. For this particular message, we can generate the two string section. Where is the two string? Here we are having two string with help of this particular three values here. Now I'm generating this particular two string, and here we can go for the sysout message here. Okay, right now what we can do, so this is, we are going to use, I'm trying to load the object here. Now you can see what we are doing here. We are trying to load the object from this particular database. Now what happens internally, this is important here. Here now you can see, so select message ID as this particular message ID, message text we are having, next message ID. From where it is trying to load here? From this particular message, and internally we are using this particular order by message text here. Okay, order by message text. Now what happens internally? This condition is failed here. Why this particular condition is failed? Here we are making, if it is empty, if it is empty only, we are printing. But this is wrong here. We need to make not condition. If it is not empty only, we need to print this particular values. Now you can see, now you can see what happening internally. I'm trying to load the one more time here. Now observe here. So this is the select query is generated, and internally this is a message record here. Okay, message ID 1, and this is the text message, and the next message, so far we did not provide any record. So now it is printing the first record here. Okay, this is the another query we need to use to load the object from the database here. Okay, now another important information we need to use here, something like here. So instead of this particular find here, now I'm going to use another important section, session dot load here, session dot load. Now what you can do here, this particular load, what happens internally, is expecting the class information, message dot class we need to provide, and ID. What is the ID we can provide here? Something like new long here, we can provide the ID okay, this is the ID. So this particular ID also deprecated here, so we can go for this. Otherwise what we can do, long dot value of something like 1 here. Okay, this is the second parameter we can provide. First parameter is expecting the object, And the second parameter is expecting the ID. The ID, right now we are having only one. I am giving this particular ID. And finally, I will try to print this section using this particular println here directly, because it will try to return the single object here. The load method, it will try to return the single object. The find method, it will try to return the list of objects. So this is the difference we need to understand here. Now you can see we are going to see this particular two records here. First one is coming from this particular load method. Second one is coming from the particular find method. So here we are using the find method, and here we are using this particular load method. Both are same, but what we can understand, the find method is returning list of messages here, but load class, like load method, whatever the load method we are having, it's trying to return single object. Okay, now you can see this particular load method internally, it is trying to return the object here. Okay, this is important here. Now what I will do here, I'm going to provide the 10 record here. The ID I'm giving as a 10. Now we need to understand here what happens internally. Now you can see no row with this particular given identifier exists. Whatever this particular ID we are providing here, we don't have a record here. Based on this particular ID, we don't have a record here. This is important here. This is very important information we need to understand. Whenever the ID does not match here, we are going to get an exception with the help of this particular load method. Okay. Now find method, we are going to provide the query. So based on this particular query, if any records are matched here, it will return. Otherwise, this particular list is empty. So this is, we need to understand very carefully. Now what I am doing here, I am going to provide the particular section information. Now you can see the find I am going to remove from here. Otherwise we can comment out here. And another section, this condition also we can comment out. Now what we are doing here, with the help of this particular load method, I am trying to load the object here. Okay, I am trying to load the object here. And this object, I'm trying to setting a old message. Okay, so this is the object I'm trying to set as a old object. And here, what happening internally? So I had to cast this particular message. Now it will convert into the message class. After converting this particular message class, now what I'm doing here? So using this particular message only, now what I'm doing here, I'm going to provide something like here, old message dot text. So whenever I'm trying to add this particular text here, it will modify here. Okay, it will modify the existing text here. Whatever the existing text we have, the text is going to modify. Now you can see, so something like a new message I'm adding here, the text here. So earlier the text we added as a welcome to Hibernate. Now it is replaced with this particular new message. And after this message, next message I'm trying to create here. And here, so here this next message is the boss of our let me write here next message only. Okay, new object I'm creating. This is important. And this new object I'm trying to set into the old message. Old message dot set to next message. And here next message I'm setting. Getting the point? Here I'm trying to provide the next message. Now I'm not going to save this particular session related section here. This is important information we need to understand. Here I commented session dot save also. So whenever I'm trying to run this particular example, observe carefully how it is working internally. Now observe what happening internally. This is very important. We need to understand. First, we are loading an object. Okay. And we are trying to load the max ID and we are trying to inserting. And later we are updating. How many operations is doing at the same session here? So first one is selecting here. Okay. Second one is identifying the max value. And third one is it is trying to inserting here. And fourth one is it is trying to update here. These are all the four operations are doing. But if you see, insertion operation is doing without the save method. Without the save method. This is important. We need to understand here. If you go to this example here, we are not using any the save here. Now you can see I commented the section. I commented this particular section. What I'm doing is session dot load only. The session dot load, after this I'm creating the old message I'm modifying it, new message I'm creating it, and I'm trying to set into the old message. After this, so I'm trying to commit the transaction, I'm closing this particular session here. Getting the point? Now what you need to understand basically here, we need to understand this is the important section here. This is basically, we'll call it as a automatic dirty checking. This automatic dirty checking, what it will do, it will try to update, it will try to insert based on the existing object modification, because this existing object, now it is available under this particular session. If anything is happened inside the current session, automatically it will update it. So before committing this particular changes, whenever you are trying to commit this particular changes, what happens internally, it will try to insert or it will try to update based on the modification, and later that will commit the changes here. Okay, later it is coming here. This is the important section, we'll call it as a automatic dirty checking. Okay, this is important here. It is going to save the lot of efforts whatever we are doing. So if I want to run this particular explicitly, first we need to load, second we need to insert here, and the third we need to do the updation, but everything internally it is going to take care of this particular session. Okay, now we are inside the same transaction, same session and the same transaction. Because of this, so it is trying to update. Any questions on this? Any questions on this particular values here?
So can we see the values in the database, sir?
Okay, sure. Now if I'm going to run this, now you can see the new object is created with help of this particular ID 2, and the old object is modified here. Now you can see the mapping here. So how we are getting this particular mapping here? Here now you can see, so this is the old message I modified as a new message, and later I'm creating the new object here. So this object record, how much the value we are going to get? So 2, because already one record is already existed here, so it will become, because we are trying to use the increment, it will become 2. So for this record it is a 2, and this next message, whatever the next message we created, again I'm trying to set into the old message. Whenever I'm trying to set into the old message, the ID will be set, not the object, because it is a object mapping, so that it is going to set only ID. What is the ID it is setting? The second. Why it is setting the second? Because here next message. What is the next message we are having? So this is only the next message. This is only the next message. Because of this, it is trying to load the object and it is inserting with help of this particular tool, and after that it is trying to update here. Okay, so based on this ID only, it is updating two fields. First one text field, second one is next message. So now you can see the ID. This is the ID, one is the old object, and we created the new object. Now it is mapped to the old object with help of this particular ID 2. Okay, so is it clear?
Sir, so welcome to Hibernate. In that place, now we have new message.
So right? Here you can see right here. 21 new messages we added.
Okay, sir. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, so any other questions? Okay. So if we don't have anything, now I'm going to stop the session up to here. Anything you want to discuss?
Sir, what is the difference between Spring and Hibernate?
See, Spring is different, right? With help of the Spring, we are not connecting the databases. So Spring internally, it is using the different to the concept. If you see here, templates we use here. Here, if you go to this particular person, DOMPL, that JDBC template. The template internally, it is communicating with the databases. So if I want to communicate with the same Hibernate, we have a Hibernate template also. Okay, Hibernate template, with the help of this particular Hibernate template, we are going to communicate like a databases. So we will not discuss this particular Hibernate template as of now. But Hibernate entirely, the new concept we are discussing, this is the different frameworks, or we can call it as a ORM tool, we can call it basically. So this ORM tool, we are going to communicate with the databases with a lot of automations here. Like if you see the table, we did not create it and we did not provide the value, ID values. So everything internally, it is take care of the values, like incrementing the section of values, and based on the Hibernate mapping file, the table is created. But these kind of the features, it is not available in the Spring. Okay, Spring is a one framework. It is contained with the different modules here. Like I identify the core module. Now we discuss in the last session, like how we can communicate with the databases. Like in the upcoming classes, we'll discuss the how we can integrate the like a front-end related sections. Okay, how we can communicate with the security. These are all the different modules we are having in the Spring. But all the concept is no longer available in the Hibernate. So Hibernate is specifically, it is going to provide the information to the databases here. How we want to communicate with the databases with the different styles here, like with a multiple objects or single object, and what are the different interfaces we are having, different classes we are having. Getting the point. So these are all the different concepts we are having here. So once you are familiar with the Hibernate, you can easily understand what exactly the Hibernate is going to purpose. Okay, so don't compare with the Spring and Hibernate. Spring is different, Hibernate is different. Spring will contain the different module. It is going to perform the different operations. But Hibernate is specifically to communicate with the databases.
Okay.
Okay. So any questions?
No, sir. Thank you.
Okay. So tomorrow we'll discuss about the Hibernate architecture. What are the interfaces we are having and what exactly the each and every interface is going to connect internally. So once we're familiar with this particular interfaces, we'll try to continue the mapping sections, like whenever we are discussing about the multiple objects, how we are going to map, we'll try to discuss about the each and every example.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.